Hello guys, welcome to my channel. This is Evans Emmanuel. I'll be your host for today. I'll be talking about the fundamentals of using Excel. Excel is a very versatile tool and very interesting to use, very easy to use. You can easily use it for business intelligence, for basic analysis, for data analytics, production analytics, anything, name it, you can use it. Accounting, people can use it to easily analyze inventory and other things. Excel has proven to be a very strong tool in analyzing things, in fetching data, extracting data, predicting future data. But we will not be looking too deep now. We'll just be looking at the fundamentals in just 1 hour, how to use Excel in just 1 hour. I'll be touching important places like the ribbon, the tabs, the groups, the back end. You will understand. Definitely, I'll make sure you understand all these things, and you will be able to write your first program after you have watched this event. So just follow me and make yourself free, because in learning, you don't have to be stiff in learning. Just try to understand the processes and you'll be fine. Follow me. Join me as we start. This is the basic interface of Excel. This is the home screen if you have clicked the Excel button. Mind you, I'm using the Excel 2019 edition. I will suggest you start using from 2013 upward. If you are using the lower product, maybe 2010 or 2007, it will not be nice because it cannot give you the basic functionalities that you want. You need to do so many things with Excel. 2007 is so much limited. It has limits rather. But with the 2013 upward, you can easily do things like macros, add buttons, make Excel an application, and other things. But before then, let's just dive into what we are here for. Let's leave other ones for the advanced users. But for now, let's make you an advanced user. So for now, this is the back end of an Excel file. This is the back end. This is where we pick what we start with. These other ones are called templates. We'll not be working with templates today. We'll be working with a blank workbook. I will go ahead and click it. And this is our basic Excel environment. Okay, this is the Excel environment. This is what we call our ribbon. Guys, let me highlight it for you. This whole section is called the ribbon. This whole section is called the ribbon. These sections are called tabs, the Excel tab. Okay, this is the file tab, this is the home tab, insert tab, and other tabs. Okay, in each of these tabs we have what we call groups. Therefore, now let's look at other part of this. This is a group. This is a group. That is clipboard is a group under home. Font is a group under home. Alignment is a group under home. Numbers is a group under home. Styles, cells, editing under home. We have the insert tab. Okay. This insert tab. It has tables. These are tables. This is illustration, that is your picture shapes are used for illustration. These are addings. Let's leave addings for now. These are charts. Excel is always beautiful for visualization with that chart. Okay, these are sparklines. They are also kinds of charts, but let's leave that one. These are filters. I like slicer very much. We will not touch it today. These are text box, etc. For now, I will leave the layout, but we touch everything in this video. So let's proceed. Now let's look at what we have in our home tab. Home tab. This is basically what you need for Excel for basic operations. Although you can still use it for basic operations. Actually, this the our date. What we use daily. This is what we use majorly in Excel. This can fit some of your need or most of your needs, but others can easily help you amplify your functions. But for now, let's start with the home. Okay, this is the home tab. I'll be see for easy understanding, I'll be building a program alongside the video so that you will not just learn without understanding how to use it. Okay, for now, let's call this program Excel Course by Evans Emmanuel. Okay, this is Excel Course by Evans Emmanuel. Okay, before I start talking about Excel Course by Evans Emmanuel, all these books we see that I wrote on, they are called cells. All these books, as you have seen, all of them are called cells. All the books you see are called cells. Okay, and each cells are being understood, each cells are being outlined based on the rows and the column. The rows and column makes one cell. For example, this is B6, this is B, this is 6. The name of the cell is called B6. Okay, because I chose B and 6. Watch this side, I mean watch this particular stuff, just keep watching it. When I click any part of the cell, watch what happens. I click this part, for example, this is G and this is 10, becomes G10. I click this side, for example, this is B and this is 14, that becomes B14. So definitely a cell is being numbered based on your role and your color. Oh, congratulations, you have understood what a cell is. Now you deserve a round of applause. Okay, so now let's go to the next step. This is Evans Excel Course by Evans Emmanuel. I'll be writing on these cells. Let me name this cell a serial. Okay, this cell I will name it things to cover. We will cover today, or better still, let me name it ribbons, fighters, or tabs rather, because I'll be covering tabs and each of the components in each tab. Each component, okay. Then let's leave others for now. Okay, this is serial number. You can type 1, 2, 3, but let's continue. Now this is to cut and copy. I will not touch this one for now because these ones are not physically necessary for now. Okay, this is what we call the font. Font is another name for handwriting. What I call it, handwriting. That means you are trying to rewrite something based on, you are trying to change the particular computer writing to your own desired writing. For example, I want to change Excel Course by Evans Emmanuel. I can choose this, okay, and choose this handwriting. Let's choose maybe, for example, Algeria. You see, it's changed it to this. It's not technically cool. You can find more handwriting or simply type the handwriting you want. So you can type Cooper Black. Okay, this Excel Course by Evans Emmanuel. You can now increase the boot, the handwriting, unboot the handwriting, italic, that is slant the handwriting, on italic the handwriting. You can underline it. And note, anytime you see an arrow after any member of a group, know that there are more groups inside that group. For example, there is an arrow with this U. So definitely if I click it, I can double this text, or I can just make it one, or if I don't need that at all, I click it again so it disappears. Okay, this is good. We can increase the handwriting with this. I can keep it to 18, 22, 24. You see, it's increasing the more I keep moving. Okay, let's take it to 16. You can still increase it here manually, or reduce it here manually. You see, it's very easy. Excel is not a rocket science. It's very easy, very nice to use. You don't need to be in fright to use it. You can change the color with this. I usually like using Royal Blue. I don't know why I use Royal Blue, maybe because I'm from the royal family. Okay, you can change the cell background color with this. Let's, for example, you want to change it to black. You see, you can change the cell background color with it. For now, you will not notice that everything changed because of this Excel course by Evans Manuel is flowing more than its own cell. But if I increase the cell size, you see that it covers. But for now, I will explain this for you later, because for now it will look like one strange ghost I'm trying to invite to you. Okay, let's leave this. Okay, Syria. We are done with our font in our handwriting. Now, this is technically to align these texts. I will not be using it with Evans Manuel this time. I will not be using it with Excel because by Evans Manuel this time. I will be using it with this. Let's align this. We can align it to the middle, we can align it to the beginning, align it to the end. You see, these are also alignment techniques, but this is when the space in between each of the width of the cells are bigger or bigger. Okay, let's see. For example, I'm increasing the size of one. You see, the middle work perfectly, the up will work perfectly, the down will work perfectly, the middle will work perfectly. You see, I can decide to make it middle, down, remove, down, remove. That most times, note, people hardly use these ones. People hardly use these top ones. And people hardly use these top ones. Okay, so we'll not be wasting our time explaining that one. Although I've wasted more time explaining it. Okay, let's proceed. These ones are for spacing, but let's leave that one for now. Let's take this thing back so it will look like others. But it's not looking like others now. Okay, this is what we call a merge and center cell. This is what we should have done for Evans Manuel to make it center. That is, we will use this to join plenty cells together to make them one. To make them one. Okay, look, this one is C3, this is D3, E3. Be watching this place, so please watch this place. This is E3. This is F3, G3, H3, I3. But with merge and center, we make all of them one. Now this is C3. All of them are C3. Then J3. You see C3, J3. C3, J3. Okay? Now you see, these and these have differences. This one outline, this one merge cells together and make them one. This one make one of your cells to contain the whole content. Let me say it again. This one merge all your cells and make them one. Why this one maintain the content in that cell and try to increase the size of the cell just to manage all of the contents in it. Okay, let's, for example, this is each component. If I click this, see what happens. It tries to make sure it accommodates everything in one cell. So you see, very nice. Hope Excel is not that difficult. Okay, these parts, numbers. This is what we call number formatting group. Number formatting group. We use this particular place to tell each cell which format or which cell format it should accept. We are trying to tell each cell, like this is numbers, or these are numbers rather. These tabs can be in text form. This one, okay, let me add one extra headings. We can call field rather, because Excel we call it field. One extra field we call currency. For example, this currency, even though I don't know that we use it, but let's just leave it that way. Okay, this is Syria. We can see Syria should be in numbers. This is, you see, I can change it. Numbers. Note, numbers we have what we call decimals. Okay, let's say numbers. You see that we have decimals. Numbers are decimal, you see. You can use this to remove the decimals, and you can use this to increase the decimal, you see. Very easy. You can use this to add percentage, or you can come here and choose percentage. You see, it's 100%, 100%. Depends on your own number formatting style. Let's leave it as general. Okay. Tabs are always good in general. Okay. The tabs we'll be working on, we are working on first is home. We have spoken about fonting, alignments. What am I spelling? Then we are talking about number formats. We are talking about, okay, let's look at editing. Okay, let's look at cells. This one I will leave it for another video, because of if I start explaining this one, this video will be very, very long. Okay, this is to add new cell. For example, you have written a lengthy stuff in this particular cell. You can use this to add new cell so that you will not delete it, maybe due to error or anything. You can add new cell with this, you see, very nice. Or you can delete the old cell, very nice. So let's leave this one. Okay, this is a good tool for accounting. But before I show you this, let me show you what this does. Okay, this is 1, 2, 3. Let's assume that we have like 30 items here. I can click this. This is how it works. You can now decide to click the fill button, and let's say series. You can see it should start from 1. So maybe 40. Let's see how it goes. 1 to 40, you see, very fast, you have written 1 to 40 in a twinkling of an eyes. Yeah, you see, very easy, you don't need to stress yourself with Excel. Okay, we have talked about home, we can increase, we can bold it, it's very nice. Okay, for example, let's, is currency actually important? Let's give it numbers, or let's just say currency. Let's assume fonting is 5. Okay, let me change the currency. You can use accounting, any of these two works. Okay, you can use currency. Let's say 5, 5, 5. You see, it's showing dollars. You can decide to change your currency. You can set to format your currency to a currency as it concerns your country. You can click, sorry, my mouse is turning to a rat. You can click this and choose the currency of your choice. You can come here, more accounting format, and change it to different currency as it concerns your country. Like, as a Nigerian man, I use Naira, Igbo. Okay, you see, it's showing Nigerian Naira for me. Okay, this is another tool, we call this one sort and filter. You use to sort or filter. Okay, let's see how it works. To sort, you are sorting from a particular, the particular way you like it. To sort something does not mean you are hiding it. You are making, you are showing us the standard, how you want it to look like. Is it from lowest to highest, from A to Z, from Z to A? You see, let's say from A to Z, and you see, expand, I said expand, yeah, expand. You see, very good. It tries to expand, you see. Note, home was with font before, so it tried to expand. So But if you do not click that expand, you might end up losing or mixing up your data, which is not good for you. Okay, so the next one is, let's try filter. Okay, filter will show you things that you want to show. Okay, for example, let's click this, say show font, show number format. Okay, for example, I say show only font, it hides others. That's filter for you. But for now, when we end, you start using Excel for professionals or for God, I will show you how best to use it. But for now, let's take out this filter. It's not useful for now. So we are done with the home screen. For the home tab, let's go straight up to the insert tab. Okay, this insert tab, this is where we insert or we add new items or components in our cells. We add new components in our environments or new things. It can be in form of pictures, it can be in form of shapes, it can be in form of charts, it can be in form of text box, anything. The main thing is we are adding new stuff. Okay, for now let me change this to any kind of numbers. Okay, let's, we are now straight up to what we call, okay, I've not added this in yet. Okay, let me add this in. Let's go. We are now in insert. Let me bold it. You can use Ctrl B to bold it. Okay. Ctrl B to bold. Okay. To insert. You can insert a new table. Okay. Let's, for example, I want to convert this to a table. I will align it. Then press this. Here is the data at your table. I've highlighted where my data is. Does my table have header? I say yes, it has an header, and boom, we have the table. We can decide to format the table anyhow we like it. You see, anyhow we like the table, we can format it the way we like it. Okay, let's use this. This table is nice and very attractive. Okay, we are now using table, still on insert. Pivot table is for picture class. Okay, the next one is what? Picture, we can insert picture. Okay, let me see if I have a picture yet to insert. Okay, I should have picture yet to insert. Wow, there are a lot and lot of pictures here. Let me just pick this one. I don't know what the amount is then. Is it then? It's scary. You can reduce the size from here. Okay. You can reduce it the way you like it and put it anywhere on the screen. Okay, let's click out before we are done with it. Click the insert as usual. Now let's add shapes. This is where we add shape. We can add any kind of shape. Let's use a star because I'm a star boy. The star doesn't make any sense. You can still edit it any way you like it. So it's very easy to do. But for now, this does not have any meaning to me. I can take it out. I can add another kind of shape. Let's assume I want to add this. Does this have meaning? No. Let's take it out. Okay, now you understand the concept, how to add shapes using Excel. Okay, these are for add-ins. Let's leave add-ins for now. Recommended charts. Okay, let's leave recommended charts. This, okay, let's use this. For example, I can align this and click a chart and watch this. You see, it has created the chart for me. without so much stress. You see, it created the chart based on this. I can change the chart the way I want it to be. Let's look. You see, it helped me to analyze it on its own without so much stress. But do I really need this kind of chart? You see, giving error, one error, you know. You know how to calculate this. That is a 360 this thing.
Come on.
Let's remove this chart. We can use any other chart. There are different charts here. You see, so many persons prefer using something like this. You see, it shows chart is majorly for visualization. You see. You see, very nice. Okay, let's leave this one here. Let's edit. But you know what? To make the charts explain or speak, we should do it this way. We are light. Okay, let me add something. Let me add it now, for example, here. And then alight these two. This will easily help the chart. For that way, the chart was not saying anything. Nice talking. Because the beauty of a chart is when it can communicate. Now, this chart is communicating something. Now, the chart will make you know that we are trying to compare four things: alignment, font, numbers, and editing. You see, very nice. It's communicating now. Okay, let me leave it here or change the. Okay, this is very good. I like this. 5, 9, 7, 9, 9, 8, 9. Very good. It speaks volume of what we have here. Okay, you see, we have inserted charts in just no time. Okay. You can insert any kind of chart. You can insert a slicer. Okay, this is a slicer. What a slicer actually does. Formerly, I wanted to skip it, but I just have to insert it. Okay. They will show me serial. No, don't show me serial number. Show me only tab, page, currency, and let's go. This is what a slicer actually do. You can show things based on how. Okay, this will not be nice until we have a better data on the screen. For now, we don't have enough or sufficient data. When we have sufficient data, we'll show you how the slicer works. Slicer is a very nice tool. The filter is also a filtering tool. Very nice to filter. I prefer using slicers to filter than to using the traditional filter tool to filter. Okay, these are spark lines still. For visualization, this is a text box. Okay, this is basically not too necessary in Excel. You can put a text box and type whatever you want to type. It's easier to type directly with Excel. If it is for Microsoft Word, text box can still be nice. But okay, let's just use it. For example, my course. This E, okay. Let's increase bold, increase. You can take it anywhere you want it to be. You see. But it has no basic use for it. Okay. So remove this. Now, if you see, if I put it here, it's covering some things. You can remove this. Using shape fill, you see no fill, then you can see no outline, to remove the outlines too, so that it becomes every other thing. So you see, it can now be attached to any part of the cell. Normally, a text box is usually used as an attachment tool to add new things where you see that there is there is difficulty in tweaking the cell to do that. You use a text box to do that very easily. For example, I want to add a new thing to this chart title. You can still change this chart title by clicking and changing it. I forgot to even show you this. You can change the chart title here. Very easy to do. You can change other things with this, but for now let's not change. Okay, we have spent a lot of time. This text box, this header, these are equations. We are not going here to this place before some people will hate me for introducing them to Excel. You see, these are not for you, it's not even for me. These are symbols to add symbols to Excel. You can add any symbol. Look at Naira now. In case of you don't have Naira in your today's thing, you can check the symbols if you have Naira in your symbols. Look at different symbols you can choose from. You see, you can choose from different symbols from here. But these are not technically okay. Let's proceed. Let me close this. We have checked different parts in the insert tabs. Okay, we checked the tables, the illustrations, the charts, features, here we have the slicer, and also the text, then symbols. Okay, now we are looking at the next tab, the page layout. Page layout is technically telling Excel how your page should look like. This is where we choose our theme for the page. This is the theme, you see, these are themes. So how did page themes? Okay, let's say we want to work with this one. This is the default one. These are theme colors. This is where we set our margins. Margins, you will not notice margin now until it's time to print. Majorly, it's better you use normal. But if you want to, for those that want to save paper, I don't know why they are saving paper, you choose narrow. But it's better you choose normal so that each of the edge will have spaces. This is to set it either portrait, street, or landscape. It is for this particular stuff we are using portrait. You can choose landscape. It will stretch it. Okay, let me show you how it will look like. Okay, let's say print preview. This is landscape. You see. But I'd rather use portrait. I prefer using portrait. You see all these settings are still here. Narrow, this is narrow. That is narrow. You see, if we stretch it to the end, so let's use normal. Okay, this is it. Let's go back to portrait. You see, very good, perfect, and nice. Note, all these settings are still here. Let me close this. All the settings are still underneath. Let me remove my face. These are still the settings. Therefore now, let's proceed to the next part. Okay. This size, print area, background color or background style, scalings. We can use one to remove all these lines on the screen. Let's see. You see, there are no more lines on the screen. But Excel, we know more the Excel if there's no line yet. But the lines help you scale easily. So let's bring back our line. Okay, headings. To remove these headings on the screen. Okay, let's remove it. You see, but it's not nice this way. Let's add it back. Because without the headings, we cannot easily track the cell number. So let's lift back our headings, bring the Bible to the front. I will leave this one for another day. Formulas. This is where all your formula libraries are being placed. This is your DOSUM. So this is your basic mathematical formula. For example, let's see what this one does. AutoSum easily add up every part of that selected. You see this 29. If I light this, you'll see the same 29 here. Same 29. You see this is 1, 2, 3, 4. Four counts. That average of 7.5. You can still get all these formulas there. You see average there, 7.5. You see maximum. Which number is the maximum? 29. Which number is the minimum? 5. Okay. These are more functions. Let's leave those ones for now. These are recently used financial calculation. You can easily calculate your NPV with this, but clicking it now will not calculate anything. You not calculate anything until you fill in this. You feel that I will show you how to use this one later in future videos. Okay, this is where we have data. Okay, let me fill in this page layout first. That we see amazing things we can do with it. We have the touch teams, touch each setup, the touch sheet options. Okay, with no touch arrange, so I'm gonna add that formulas, the touch only formulas. Touched functions. Function library. Okay. Let's touch something. Can define the name of this table here. Highlight the whole table and call it a name without defining. Then I call it table list, table 1, workbook, comment, blah blah blah. Okay, so you have to join each. Have to join the name together, make it one. You see, the name already exists, name should be unique. Okay, it already exists, already in existence. The name is table new. Okay, let's see. Perfect, this table is now what? Table new. Let's see, name manager. You see, table new is not in existence, but we just added it. Okay, you can use a formula etc. This is basically why we name tables, basically for people reason. For to use pivot table to show relationship between tables, you have to name these tables, because of it will not, you cannot easily name, you cannot easily link things you don't know their names. So definitely you have to name these tables so that you can easily join them together. Okay, without saying much things, let's proceed to other things. This data, okay, get external data. This is if you want to source data from other sources. You can get data for your Excel from Access, you can get it from the web, you can get it from text. Now this is basically this from web. You can easily get any kind of data from the web and use Excel to cleanse it, make it new once again, and it becomes nice for analysis. So So Excel is I told you before that Excel is a very powerful tool for data analytics and for business intelligence analytics, because of you can easily get data, cleanse this data, describe this data, predict with this data, prescribe with this data, visualize this data, tell stories with this data. So Excel is very powerful for business intelligence. You can even still get data from other sources. You see, these are different sources. You can get data from, let's leave this existing connection first. This is new query. These ones, I'm not touching them for now, except we start using pivot table thing, or pivot table rather. I will start showing you how these things work. These are different connections. This is still the same sort you see in your home tab and page layout tab. You see, they still repeat it. This one, wow, this particular data part is a very rich part in data analytics and business analysis. This text to column is another tool to convert text to tables like this. It's very easy. You can decide to use either commas from the text, or space from the text, or semicolon from the text to distinguish these data, to make them a table-like data to ease analysis. Okay, this is data validation. Okay, let me show you how this thing works. I like using it sometimes. You are using this data validation to give rules of what you want Excel to do. You are giving rules. Okay, for example, let's say this is okay, name, better still, gender. For example, the gender, I can give data validation that in these cells, that is, these cells are outlined, please accept only whole number, decimal, list, data, date, time, length, blah blah blah. Let's just use list for example. List. Let's use lists. Okay, better still, let me create the list. I've not created the list. Okay, for example, I create the list. This gender, male, female, 30s. Let's leave it this way. Male, female, not specified. Okay, you can easily do it this way. You align this and choose OK. Let me give this thing a rule. Please, Excel, accept only data from a particular list. Let me pick the sort by, which is this, and I press OK. And Excel will say OK. And I say OK. Excel will answer me OK. For example, this is the gender. I click here. It's telling me is it male, female, or specify female. I cannot type anything. If you tell me bound, you can see. Okay, we can give this rules. Okay, for example, this is input message. Okay, try to choose properly. Okay, see, please select the appropriate gender. Okay, let's see. You see, for example, I type nonsense, she still give me the error because of I did not give it an error name. Okay, let me give it an error name. This error alert. Okay, let's see. Stop. Choose appropriately. Oh. Hello there. I'm using there. I don't know. I'm using there. Hello there. Choose the gender for the job down lists. Okay. Let's see. Okay. I'm choosing. Let's say I type nonsense. You see, it does not match. Okay, it seems that they want to play with me. Let's see this mail. Okay, now I see. You have to select, you have to alight the full. You have to select the full stuff and select it, you see. Okay, choose information. Let's change this time information because we are showing information. Okay, let's see what happens. I type this. It accepted. How did you accept it? Okay, the whole thing is no more there. Data validation settings. Okay. Want me to choose again? Let's not do the same error. Let's alight everything. Data validation lists. Okay, source. Yeah. Okay. Error increase. Okay. Let's do this one. It's not useful for now. Let's delete this. Let's try typing it again. I say hello there. Choose the gender from the drop down list. You see, very nice and more professional. You like it? Yes, let's proceed. So we are done with data validation, consolidation. We look at this. What if analysis? Wow, my favorite. Focus sheets. And cool. So let me type down those things we have checked. Okay, for the data. I said we have checked what the get external data. We have checked sorts and filter and data tools. Yeah, we checked that. Forecast and so we check that one later. I love that forecast and so. Review, are we checking this? For now, let's leave this one. These ones are technically to, what does it even do? It's now, this one is to check your spellings. Are we checking any spellings here? For now, no. This is to check like a synonyms to a particular word. That is what SLS does. Synonyms and antonyms of a particular word. Different synonyms. All these reviews are majorly very good when you are using Microsoft Word. But for example, at most times people hardly check spellings, people hardly check text errors, smart lookup, translate. People don't translate easily except you are analyzing a data and you want it to be to easily speak to a larger audience, maybe an audience from different part of the world, Igbo, Yoruba, China, Asia, Africa, Europe, anywhere from any part of the world. You can use this translate to change the languages of your data for these different groups of indigents or individuals. Okay, this is to protect your sheets or your protect your workbook, etc. Okay, we are not looking at review for now. Okay, view, this is view. View is very good. Okay, for example, let me go back to the review. Let's, for example, I check review. Maybe I claim I did improving insights language protect. For example, I'm telling this is just for instance. Okay, let me go this. Let me copy the way I did for that. Okay, for instance, and let me check this view. This view is how you want your screen to look like. Note, page layout is for the page. View is for the screen itself. Note, page layout is for what? The page. Although there are some part of it, because normally a page is also in the screen. The view is for the entire screen, how it will look like. Page layout at most times when you want to print out the particular settings you make to make your print out a standout. That's it. That's for page layout. The view is the overall environment, how you want it to look like. That is what it means. It does not concern how your printing style will look like. No, it does not concern. This is just how it will be very good for you to look at your screen. You can decide to look at it like this. Some people see this as a standard. Me, I don't see this as a standard. I don't like this, so I click it. It's not good. I choose normal. Some people prefer it this like this, page layout. Me, don't like it like this. If you are good with this, good and fine. You can go with it. Hallelujah. You can go with it. Good and fine. For me, I prefer using the normal view. I showed you this, how to use this in page layout to remove the grid line, add it back, remove the formula bar, which I will not dare do in real life, but you can add it back. Because formula bar is one important reason why Excel is Excel. Without the formula bar, Excel is no more the Excel we love using. This is to zoom. Why am I even zooming? You can zoom 200. You see how? Okay, let's zoom and see. Okay, do you like it like this? No, let's take it back to 100. You see, very good and fine. This is to create a new window. Okay, let me show you what this actually does. That's the reason why I added this particular stuff. That's the reason why I just added it. Now, this is what it does. It helps you view your particular window in a very nice way you would like to use it. It helps you view your screen the way you want to see it. For example, now, let's assume this tab, this serial number tab and components are more, or let's say gender, these parts from these headings to these headings are more important to me to view. I will click here, or click here rather, and then click freeze pane. So when I click freeze pane, I can scroll down and these things keep showing. So you see, because they are very important for me to view. You see, I can start to check it this way. You see, okay, now you understand why what they use freeze pane for. Okay, because I chose this side, that's why it was showing that way. Okay, let me choose here instead, so that both the column, gender, coins and everything can easily show when I move to the right. Okay, let's see on freeze first, then let's freeze this pane. Let's see how it works. You see everything is showing here. And everything is showing here. Very perfect. Now this is how we use Excel. You see, we have checked the whole ribbon. We have checked the tabs. We have checked the key different groups in each tabs. Okay? You see, now let's check the file tab. This is the last tab we'll be looking at. This tab is actually very important because this is what we call the back end of Excel. If you want to add a new file, you click this to add a new file and click the new file. Okay, but since we are not using this one, let's go back to our old file. We can minimize this one and go back to our old file. This is sheets. Note, each of these pages are called sheets. So you can add new sheets with this. You see, very easy. You can rename. So let's say this is Destron. This sheet is what? Second page, I beg. Let's call it second page. Okay. Let's leave it this way. You can play with anything here and still go back to your sheet. You'll be asking what is the use for all this sheet. Now, in sometimes you get data and you want to analyze them based on geographical locations. You can choose to put here Americans, this here Africans, here Europeans, here you see. So it's basically to categorize things, to categorize data. That's why it's good like this. Because if you are creating new pages or new workbook for it, because I forgot to tell you this, Excel save as a workbook, whereas Microsoft Word save as a document. So when you try to create a new workbook for each of these categories, you tend to start opening workbook one at a time, which is not a good practice. The best practice is to add new workbook, new pages or sheets rather, in your book. Since this is a workbook, you are scrolling the pages of the book with this. This is page 1, this is your page 2, page 3, page 4, till page infinity, as you like. Okay? This is our save. This is to undo. This is to redo. Okay? We are going to back to our back end. Let me go back to my first page or my first sheet. Going back to the work back end, I showed you what a new is. Open is to open existing files, the files we have created before. To save is to save our work. Okay, let's save this work as what should I call it? Let's say Emmanuel course overview. And for Excel, let's make it long. Save. Now, and this is it. Evans Emmanuel course overview for Excel. Tell me what to do. You can't see it in a lower version of Excel. This is basically in from 2016 we show you what we call inquiry. 2019 we show you tell me what you want to do. This is just like a suggester. It suggests actions you should take. Okay. That's it. Let me remove this gender. It does not have any meaning for now. Okay. Okay, let me introduce formula for you. Let's introduce formula. Let's, for example, this one to accumulate. You can clean up this. There's one thing I have to tell you in Excel. There's one thing I have to tell you in Excel. There is one thing I have to tell you in Excel. Let me pause this video and bring it, make it good. Okay, I've restarted the video again. To save or to edit any part of the cell, you have to click that cell. When you click it, you press F2 to edit. You see, very easy. Because if you just click and try to edit, you end up overwriting that data. You either double click or you press F2. You see, Excel is not hard, it's not for the weak. Okay, let me show you formulas, how to add formulas. To add formulas, the best practice is to use equals sign. Some uses plus. I don't like plus actually. I prefer using equals to. Okay, to add formulas, you use equals to and you communicate to Excel based on the cell number. That's why I told you that selling or cell numbering is very vital. For example, I want to calculate cell E6 with E7. I can click here. Okay, this is already in table, so let me type it manually. So this is E6, E6 plus E7. You see, it's showing me. Then press enter. Okay, this is in table, it helped me to calculate everything. But if it is not in table, it will not calculate. It will only calculate that particular cell I want it to calculate. Okay, let me just fill these things up. wait for me. Okay, I'm done filling this thing up. Okay, let me edit this place and call it, what am I calling it? Cumulative values. Okay, we can still do other things. We can still add more formulas. This is technically just to show you how it works. That's what I'm just trying to do. Let me take this boy somewhere else. Okay, let me add. Okay, let me show you easy formula. Request equals to add. This formula is called addition to add two numbers. What you just need to do is equals to select, let's assume this is it, plus this, you give me what, this value. You can easily do other things. Okay, for example, we can auto sum everything. Auto sum is not hard. Let's, for example, I want to auto sum, I press equals to sum. You can easily sum by press equals to sum brackets. You come up. You press this. And then you choose this to go down. Cover it and you see it has already summed it up. But you can easily use this format, which is very easy to use. Use it auto sum, you press it and you see it gives you the same answer. Okay, this is how we round up for this video, not to make it lengthy. Okay, then this is the back end. I'll show you what this is used for. Is to save. Yes, I'll save. You can save as share to other people or other, this is save to cloud, email, anyhow. You can export, you can close it here, options, account. Okay, thank you guys for joining me in this ride. I so much appreciate your work, I so much appreciate the effort. Join me in this channel to easily understand fundamentals of Excel and also to use Excel like a god. I have different ways to use Excel. You can use Excel to build company softwares. I will be showing you that if you follow me closely. So thank you. I hope you gained value. If you gained value, please help me like this video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Evans Manuel, love you. I say have a very good day. Thumbs up for this.